please remain standing for the presentation of the colors by the San Bernardino County Fire Department Honor Guard, accompanied by the San Bernardino County Professional Firefighters Pipes and Drum Band. Please be seated.
Time on! Take! Sit!
So here we are again, 16 weeks later. It wasn't that bad, was it? I'd like to do some introductions. If I could have the chief officers present, please join me up on the stage. I'll start here. We have local 935 president Jim Gregoli, deputy chief John Chamberlain, division chief Dave Corbin, fire marshal Mike Horton, assistant chief Tim Porter, assistant chief Dave Mejia, assistant chief Ron Walls, Assistant Chief Dan Muncy, Assistant Chief Jeff Birchfield, and it's my honor to introduce Fire Chief Mark Hartwig. Our first speaker is going to be Fire Chief Mark Hartwig.
They told me I was speaking. They didn't tell me when. I guess it's now. Welcome. Welcome to the families. I missed you at Family Day. And so you know that I'm real. I am here. Welcome. And congratulations. Congratulations to our Tower 9, but I know well enough to know that it's a congratulations to you as well. You made it as well. We know that they're successful because you support them, regardless of what role you play in their lives. You help them get to the point that they are today. I use this as an opportunity to address you as families, but I also can't pass up the opportunity to challenge these men and women that we have before us. 7 years ago, I returned home to an organization that wanted to be better. Quite frankly, that needed somebody to tell them that they could be better. I grew up in an organization that sat around the coffee table after dinner drinking coffee or at shift change in the morning, dreaming about what this organization could be, mostly all ears, really, and taking lots of notes. But found myself drifting off, thinking about what this organization could and should be. Interestingly, when I came 7 years ago back home, I was confronted by two attitudes. One was that of those leaning forward, pen in their hand, a notepad out, and taking notes as to how they thought we could be better. And the other attitude was, how dare he come in to this organization and tell me that I can be better? He doesn't even know how good I am. Tower 9, I know you know this, but we will never be the organization that you dream about, that you have dreamt about for many years, more than likely, or the organization of those whose shoulders we stand on in this organization, if we are simply content to be who you are today. Dreams are an important part of being who we should be. One of my favorite authors calls them BHAGs, big, hairy, audacious goals. Goals that you just think you might be able to reach with work and determination. We're better today than we were 7 years ago, and yet we're not where we need to be. I want to challenge you, Tower 9, as we become better, this organization, and you will be a large part of who we as an organization will become, I want to challenge you to be humble. Jim Collins, in his book, Good to Great, describes it this way. Organizations become great from just being good, by having extreme humility and an intense professional will. He goes on to say that that's a paradox in today's business world, and that in the public safety or public sector, because often those that express extreme humility are weak, and that doesn't need to be the case. You can be confident and proud of who you are and what you do in this community, but you need to be humble. Intense professional will, the very characteristic that we hired many of you for, that determination and drive, can come across as cocky and arrogant. Don't be cocky and don't be arrogant. I can't wait to see what you become in this organization, the change that you make, the part that you become here at County Fire. I want to finish really by talking to you, Tower 9, but also to the families. There's a lot of attention most recently on the behavioral health issues in the fire service. They're real. You have dedicated yourself to serving others. It's a calling no greater than any other to respond to the calls for help from those that need it. And you will give all of yourself, and it will affect you. Families, because of those that have come before this tower, firefighters in this organization, and management team members, Local 935, we are developing, have developed, and continue to develop a program to help you and to help them. We have a counseling program that is open to everybody in this organization and every one of their family members, and it's not restricted to just issues related to calls for our members. It's open to you as you deal with family issues, financial issues, addiction issues, anything that you need. That service is available to you. You, Tower 9, have to take advantage of it. I have taken advantage of it. And the stigma that used to be attached to seeking help for behavioral health emergencies is lessening, and it's our job to get rid of that stigma of weakness associated with seeking help. I've been honored to represent management, fire chiefs statewide, as a co-chair with CPF, with the support of Jim Grigoli, Local 935 president, to find better ways that we as a fire service can address issues related to behavioral health. There will be more firefighters that lose their life this year associated with job-related suicide than those that die in a burning building or on a rescue. You will need help. Family, you will need to remind them that they need help, and we will have the resources for you. Tower 9, I couldn't be more proud of you. You're not quite there yet. And in fact, as you strive to be better, you can take a break. Sometimes, even as you raise a family, it might even be a break of a few years. And then focus back on that audacious goal as you serve this community and serve your family. Thank you.
Thank you, Chief Hartwig. Assistant Chief Tim Porter plays a pivotal role in our department. As the AC overseeing EMS, special operations, and training, that includes the Tower 9 Academy. Chief Porter.
Good morning. Also, going off of what Chief Hartwig said, I do want to congratulate you, the family and friends of all the trainees here. You had to be involved in support to have them be successful and be where they are. That being said, now we enter a phase called probation, where again, the trainees will continue to be pushed, pushed to be their best, to give 100%, to not give up, to not quit. They again will need your support. So I want to say thank you for supporting them. For this tower, we did something different. We brought a cadre in off the floor. These are the people that ride around on the engines, the trucks, the squads, and they were a core group of instructors over a 12-week period. I'm going to ask this cadre to come up now, and I'll name them by name and rank, if you guys can join me up here on the stage. Captain Dustin Krajeski. Captain Nathan Lopez. Captain Matt Anderson. Engineer Andrew Urbanis. Engineer Nick Turner. Firefighter John Marini. Firefighter Mark Howder. Firefighter Brandon McGarvey. Another part of this cadre that was critical in order for the tower to be successful is the training officers. I'd like to invite up Captain Steve Tracy. As well as Captain John Garber. We do have two other training officers that are unable to be here this morning because they're out teaching classes. They are Robert Stein and Robert Eady. So when we decided to pull this group off the floor, we go through a process. They're not just handpicked. They go through a selection process where they submit applications, resume. They're asked various questions from an interview panel, and we critique from there. We believe that this is the best of the best as far as the cadre goes. Time will tell as this cadre hits the floor and we see how they do in probation. But I would like to thank each one of you very much for the work that you did for this tower. You want to have a seat? One thing I do want to mention about that cadre is when they're pulled off the floor, they're on a 56-hour work week normally. When they're pulled off the floor, it's not an 8-to-5 job, and you as the family members of these men understand that. Many times the day would start at 5 or 6 o'clock in the morning and would not end until 6, 7 o'clock, sometimes later at night. So for you, the families of this cadre, I'd like to thank you as well for allowing us to use them like we did for the 12-week period that they were in training. Tower 9, I'm going to take a minute to address you guys and gals. I got to know a little bit of you over the last 16 weeks or so. Some of us had some frank, sometimes we had some frank talks, probably not some exciting talks. I'll go back and I remember one talk was the first or second week of the tower. I see some grins down there on the first row, but I didn't think you guys were giving it 100%. I remember at Family Day, one thing that we said was we expect 100% from our firefighters, whether it's a trainee all the way up to the chief officers. We expect the best of the best. And we expected nothing less of you guys. One of those talks we had with the entire cadre when I came in, I said, if you guys make me come down here and put my shoes on and do what you guys are doing, I will smoke every one of you guys, either it's running or whatever it is that's going on. As I looked down at my peers, they may be thinking, really? But I can tell you that I would. I'll still stick to my word. Now, you guys are in much better shape and conditioning, and this would be a challenge. I want to say that I'm very proud of you guys and what you've accomplished. Take the day, enjoy it, enjoy the day with your families. Some of you start work on Saturday. This is the greatest job there is. Don't take it for advantage. You still have a year probationary period to go through. I told you guys the first week of the tower that you need to buddy up with somebody. Still buddy up with somebody. You're a team, but work with your buddy. Families, they still need the support. There's still going to be those shifts when they'll come home and they'll say, oh, that was a bad shift. We went through this and this and this and this. They'll come home and say, it was a great shift. They did this. This is a job that's very challenging. It will push you, no matter what your rank is, to perform your best. Giving up is not an option. We started this tower the week before the tower with 54 people that had agreed to come to the tower. The first day we had 47. We're graduating 32, I'm sorry. So that's all part of the process of us picking the best. It was difficult releasing the people that were off on injury, releasing the people that didn't perform. But we owe it to you, the citizens of the community, of the county, to know that you're getting the best care and treatment that you can get from San Bernardino County Fire Department. That's why we hold such a high standard. In closing, Chief Hartwig mentioned some goals and stuff. I would challenge you guys to write goals down, whether they're 5-year goals, 10-year goals, write your goals down. That will help you guide your way down your road in your life, in your future, as you decide to promote up in the fire service or move on with your families and continue on that road as well. I will leave you this one thought. If you think you can, you can't. If you think you can't, you can't. Either way, you're right. Congratulations, Tower 9.
Thank you, Chief Porter. Our final speaker is Tower 9 class leader, trainee, Dustin DeAngelis.
All right. Good morning, family, friends, loved ones, and fire family. My name is Dustin DeAngelis, and I've had the honor of being the tower leader during this very special time of our lives. Tower 9, we did it. 4 months, 16 weeks, and 2,920 hours, but who's counting? From long days to stressful and sleepless nights, we have learned many skills, from countless hose pulls, ladder throws, firefighting tactics, ventilation, auto extrication, techniques, rescues, hazmat operations that we'll soon implement in the field. I remember meeting all of you on family day in this very room. We all had the same excited and nervous expressions on our faces. A statement that stuck with me on that day 16 weeks ago was from the previous tower leader. He said, find your why and you will be successful. Though the tough times and stressful moments of testing both academically and physically, we were successful in our accomplishments. From watching those close friends leave this rigorous training tower, we all dug deep and found that why. We encouraged one another, and for that, I can't thank you enough. We started as 47 individuals, and I stand here today with 32 new brothers and sisters who I would trust with my own life. I just want to personally thank you again for what you have done for me, and I hope I have done the same for you. During the tower, we pushed one another to become the best firefighters possible. We have had major events happen in this tower. Some found out that they are going to be fathers, and others have lost loved ones who I know are looking down today with a huge smile on their face. Today is our day. We passed the physical tests, manipulative skills, and written exams. Now it's time to show the world what we have to offer. A big thanks goes out to all the cadre members, Captain Krajeski, for we are grateful for all the sacrifices you have made for us. From spending time away from loved ones and sacrificing time away from the floor to ensuring we obtain the skills set to become San Bernardino County firefighters. We are now in a position to have a positive impact on others by applying the skills we learned over the past 16 weeks. Keep showing compassion to others and lift them up in their time of need. Have a positive impact, one call at a time. Continue to grow, continue to learn, continue to be bold and take risks, and above all, continue to pay it forward. And go that extra mile, for we have just entered the most rewarding career. We will have hard days and the constant stress to perform at high expectations, just as we encountered in the tower. But like the challenges we faced, always have hope. And when you see others in need, be the first to offer a hand and lift them up. Never give up. Just think back to the days when we had run miles with our running logs, the hundreds of flutter kicks, and the famous make it rains, which consists of a set of 330 uninterrupted push-ups. We never quit, and if you want to change the world, you can never quit. The communities count on us 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. Just like our fire attack training, when you are surrounded in the darkness and you feel the heat pushing down on you, take a deep breath, stay low, and push towards the glow. Find the fire and extinguish it. Life will throw challenges at us every day. It's up to us to conquer those challenges and get the job done. Be leaders, as I know all of you are. Take the little victories and build them to accomplish your career goals. Always make time for loved ones, as they are the key to our success as we enter this next chapter of our lives called probation. There is no doubt that we will succeed in our careers as San Bernardino County firefighters. This tower has provided us with that very skill set. I would like to conclude this speech by thanking everyone again for the support throughout this process. To all the family members, friends, instructors, you have made the positive difference in our lives. Your sacrifice was as great as ours. You are the difference between us failing and standing tall on this stage today. I believe that we will make everyone in this room today proud. Thank you, everyone, and congratulations, Tower 9. And at this time, I would like to bring up my assistant tower leader, Jesse Gonzalez, as we hand out our cadre gifts to all the dedicated cadre. First off, firefighter Brandon McGarvey. Firefighter Mark Howder. Firefighter John Marini. Engineer Nick Turner. Engineer Andrew Bonis. Captain Nate Lopez. Captain Matt Anderson. And last but not least, Captain Dustin Krajeski. One big last round of applause. And at this time, we're going to present our tower plaque.
Because I know you're wondering what the trainees have been doing for the last 16 weeks, thinking that maybe they're just hanging out in the class. Trainees Samuel San Martin and Jesse Gonzalez have put together a recap video to show you what happened.
Oh. fire. Labor on that midnight wire. Listening for that angel choir. You got nowhere to run. You wanna take a drink of that promised land. Gotta wipe the dirt off of your hands. Careful, son, you got dreamers' plans. But it gets hard to stand.
Well, through the jungle until the end, I can live forever. I'll to be 18000 Institution Road, 18,000 Institution Road. Respond on BDC V4D.
Those were the days. And as class leader DeAngelis stated, these are friendships and commitments and counting on each other and teamwork that will last the rest of your lives. I'm still extremely close to all the members of my tower and academy from just a couple years ago, and these are friendships and you will count on each other for the rest of your lives. Captain Krajeski, can you please join me up front? Captain Krajeski works extremely hard and spends many hours ensuring the trainees have the best training possible. He's the arduous task of coordinating the Tower Academy, making sure all safety measures are adhered to, all the while keeping the academy running smoothly. He's also the lead instructor for modern fire behavior and the live fire training. Captain Krajeski has a couple rewards to present, but I have to get the little mic out because he can't reach this one.
I'm big where it counts, Chief. I got a big heart, so we'll just run it with that. Before I give out the awards, just a couple things. I would like to not only thank the cadre that came out off the floor and helped me. I could not have done any of this without them. You can see through that video, Chief Porter may kill me, but that's about 5,000 sheets of OSB, tons of 2x4s. I think we did fire, every training you can think of under fire to make these men and women battle ready for the citizens that we serve within San Bernardino County. So I'd like to thank them, and not only that, but I'd like to thank my lovely wife, Sheena, for supporting me over the years and allowing me to come in each year and do these towers. So we can just give them all, especially my wife, a round of applause, please. And then quickly, just a few words for you, Tower 9. At the end of the day, this is the fifth tower that I've done, and what never ceases to amaze me is the display of human spirit that I get to see every year, as we have 35 to 50 individuals come in and become a team. And at the end of the day, you displayed that the same, equal to, if not better than every other tower that's come through. And the way you did it the most is you showed heart. At the end of the day, that same heart you showed through the tower that got you through every extra pull-up, every extra mile, every extra training evolution is the same heart that is going to get you out on the floor to push down a hallway and get to the seat of that fire. It's the same heart that's going to get you to cut that child out of a car. It's that same heart that's going to have you the ability to have compassion and hold that elderly woman's hand when her husband of 50 years just passed away. You're an invaluable asset to the community, and you have a huge responsibility. You use that same heart you used to get through this tower, and you're no doubt going to be some of the best firefighters this county, this state, this world has ever seen. Congratulations. With that, we do have three awards we'd like to give out. If I can have Firefighter Marini and Firefighter Howder come up and to help me pass out the awards. Our first award is our award for academic excellence. This particular trainee did extremely well through the entire academic process. He obviously soared through and passed every test that we had. And his overall percentage academically was 96.16%. And with that, we have a wonderful axe and scabbard for him to use out on the floor. Can I get firefighter trainee Jonathan Kilgore to come up? Congratulations. Yeah, take it today. You take it. Our next award is our physical fitness award. Our PT test consists of 3 miles, 100 push-ups, 100 sit-ups, and 10 pull-ups that has to be completed in 30 minutes or less. It's a very arduous task, and it's tough. We run it quarterly. You have to at least pass it once throughout the tower in order to be successful and be up here on stage. This particular candidate not only passed all 4 PT tests, he came within a couple minutes of the record and completed that 3 miles, 100 push-ups, 100 sit-ups, and 10 pull-ups in 22 minutes and 43 seconds. That would kill most of us. So, but can we get trainee James Grovem to come on up? And lastly, we have our overall top trainee for Tower 9. This is where we accumulate the scores from everything we do, both academically, our firefighter skills testing, our physical fitness standards and testing throughout the tower. This particular candidate, when we combined all those scores, he was 101%, 0.51, did an amazing job. And it's just another display of heart, because I love doing this because it's the smallest guy in the tower. Amada, come on up. Thank you, gentlemen. And again, if I could, we can just congratulate all three of them, give them a round of applause one more time. Thank you. Good job, guys. At this time, I would like those family members who are pinning badges today to make your way to the stage right. Up the ramp is where you're going to be coming up to pin your loved one. We have Captains Steve Tracy and Engineer Bonis, and then also my wife will be helping over there get you guys ordered out. And we are going to start the badge pinning ceremony in just a moment. Each of our trainees will have their badge pinned by that special someone in their life or by Fire Chief Mark Hartwig. Deputy Chief Don Trapp will present their helmet, and Deputy Chief John Chamberlain will be presenting a certificate of recognition on behalf of the County Board of Supervisors. Recipients, after receiving your badge and helmet, you will be stepping forward to take a photo opportunity with both your family and the Chiefs. Prepare for badge pinning.
Ready, stand.
Probationary firefighter Dustin DeAngelis. Pinning firefighter DeAngelis is his fiancée, Summer Whiteside. Probationary firefighter Fabio Amata. Pinning firefighter Amata's badge will be his girlfriend Cynthia Villarino and Liana Rudis, his mother. Probationary firefighter Daniel Atkinson. Pinning firefighter Atkinson's badge is his mother, Leslie Kondrotas. Probationary firefighter Michael Bass. P- Pinning firefighter Bass is his grandfather, Michael Elson, and wife, Viviana Bass. Probationary firefighter Greg Berger. Pinning firefighter Berger is his father and mother, Dean and Diane Berger. Probationary firefighter Jordan Blanchard. Pinning firefighter Blanchard is his wife, Heather Blanchard, and daughter, Paige Blanchard. Probationary firefighter Brandon Chavez. Pinning firefighter Chavez is his mother, Susan Chavez, and Sydney Hutch, his girlfriend. Probationary firefighter Craig Cummings. Pinning firefighter Cummings is his wife and daughter, Christina and Cora Cummings.
Seats.
Probationary firefighter Anthony Ferrand. Pinning firefighter Ferrand is his father, Michael Lugo, and mother, Jana Ferrand. Probationary firefighter George Funes. Pinning firefighter Funes is his wife, Chantel Funes. Probationary firefighter Ryan Gledhill. Pinning firefighter Gledhill is his mother and father, Carla and Bill Gledhill. Probationary firefighter James Grovem. Pinning firefighter Grovem is his mother Marina and father John. Probationary firefighter Sean Hamm. Pinning firefighter Hamm is his mother, Carol Jones. Probationary firefighter Harley Hobbs. Pinning firefighter Hobbs is his mother Frances and brother Frankie. probationary firefighter Kyle Jerkins. Pinning firefighter Jerkins is his father, Captain Mike Jerkins, from the Rancho Cucamonga Fire Protection District. Probationary firefighter Megan Carlin. Pinning firefighter Carlin is her mother, father, and sister, Wendy, Bruce, and Cassandra. Probationary firefighter Jesse Gonzalez. Pinning firefighter Gonzalez is his mother Darla and father Hugo Gonzalez. Probationary firefighter Jonathan Kilgore. Pinning firefighter Kilgore is his mother Carol and father retired Tustin PD officer Patrick Kilgore. Probationary firefighter Ian Maxwell. Pinning firefighter Maxwell is his wife Rachel, mother Judith, and Natalie Taylor, his sister. probationary firefighter Michael McAngus. Pinning firefighter McAngus is his father, Gary McAngus. Probationary firefighter James McKee. Pinning firefighter McGee is his wife Anna and son Jimmy. Probationary firefighter Scott Melee. Pinning firefighter Melee is his wife Juliet and daughter Sawyer. Probationary firefighter Hilarion Meza. Pinning firefighter Meza is his mother Maria and father Placido. Probationary firefighter Austin Murrow. Pinning firefighter Murrow is his fiance, McKenna Lawrence. Probationary firefighter Justine Euler. Pending firefighter Euler is her mother Gail and grandfather Robert Inguli, retired Los Angeles Fire Department. Probationary firefighter Nicholas Papa Georges. Pending firefighter Papa Georges is his grandfather Bill Richards and mother Susan Papa Georges. Probationary firefighter Armando Reyes. Pending firefighter Reyes is his wife, Jessica. Probationary firefighter Robert Rose. Pinning firefighter Rose is his wife Kelly and daughter Sadie. Probationary firefighter Matthew Safdie. Pinning firefighter Safdie is his grandfather Don LaGrotta, his mother Amy, and father Alan Safdie. Probationary firefighter Samuel San Martin.
She's coming.
Pinning firefighter San Martin is his wife, Nicole. Probationary firefighter Jeffrey Sutphin. Pinning firefighter Sutphin is his wife, TJ. Probationary firefighter Jason Tabak. Pinning firefighter Tabak is his father, Don Tabak, retired Los Angeles Police Department detective. Tower 9, again, congratulations, and do me a favor when you're out on probation and send it.
Congratulations, Tower 9. You finished the next step. And I remember at Family Day we talked about take a moment, be proud of what you've accomplished, and get ready for the next task. And now you're here 16 weeks later. Again, take a moment, be proud of what you have accomplished, but there's still several more in front of you. Starting with probation, there'll be more challenges, more testing, more learning. But I'm going to put one more challenge on you for the rest of your career. Never become complacent. Complacency kills in this job. Either quickly, by not paying attention on an incident, not having the proper safety gear in place, or over time, by not maintaining physical fitness, taking care of yourself physically, or mental health that we talked about earlier. So always challenge yourself to be better. While watching out for complacency, setting those goals to always achieve more, and always take care of yourself and your crews. Trainees, please stand. You are now San Bernardino County professional firefighters. Make us all proud.
I want a special thanks to the Way World Outreach Church for the use of this great facility and all the volunteers that helped us accomplish this. For all the trainees and their family, we'll have our photographers both here at the stage and out in the foyer if you'd like to get additional pictures, and everyone will get emailed links of where to view all the pictures that were taken. Also, please join us for refreshments out in the foyer before you leave. Thank you for attending on behalf of Tower 9 and San Bernardino County Fire, and please have safe travels.